Drop the knife. Go ahead.
Drop it!
Good boy. Sit down, I want to talk to you. It's a wise choice. Sit down, I want to talk to you.
So who sent you?
It's Joey Zaza.
No!
Follows 11. We really need to implement the service pattern and create all of those interfaces for exposing the methods we don't know if somebody wants whenever call it. The service pattern is probably one of the most abused ever, and the heart is not bad at all. It's about exposing an API for reuse, but people tend to treat everything has to follow the pattern, leading to a lot of interface and serves IMPL classes that effectively does nothing. A service class leading to a repository because it have injection, but there's nothing wrong a controller accessing directly a repository who encapsulates the database logic. You don't have to create services if you aren't exposing an API for another model. You are just adding overhead and throwing down development cycle.
And you guarantee that they don't deal drugs in those neighborhoods?
I don't guarantee that. I guarantee I'll kill anybody who does.
Follows 12. Our system must be stateful. We need to maintain all of those complex state of objects. Second, Joe Armstrong, the inventor of the Erlang language, state is the root of all evil. Can you keep the state of the clouds? Are you sure, really? Can you imagine the complex around that? You need all infinite substates of the clouds or interest for you? Only a snapshot of the cloud on the determinate time window. Systems who treat objects' states are much more complex than stateless, because you must be careful if the values wasn't corrupted by another thread. It will use much more hard resources too. So the state maintenance must have a very strong reason, including that there are some systems where state can be maintained by security reasons. The operation must be as atomic as possible. Follows 13. Nouns are more important than verbs. Nouns are words used to name things. Verbs are words about doing things, it's about action. All word itself is based on the pure concept of class hierarchy. You can't, for example, create a function without a class. It's not possible at most of all languages, but the original idea around the world wasn't about classes, it was about methods. It's from Alan K. Message. Smalltalk is not only its syntax or the class library, it is not even about classes. I'm sorry that I long ago coined the term objects for this topic because it gets many people to focus on the lesser idea. The big idea is messaging. It makes a lot of sense because systems most of times aren't about storing things, it's about doing something. Databases store nouns, systems process data.
Ancora. Una cosa molto importante. Però te lo devo dire all'orecchio. Il potere logora chi non ce l'ha.
Follows 14. Dependence injection is mandatory every system. Not even close. DI is very handy in systems where infrastructure and maintenance is complex, like multiple data sources or multiple servers connections and bindings. This can be easy, keep using dependence injection, but you don't have to use in case of connection to a simple database. Your application server can handle the connection pool for you. DI turns much more complex than unit testing. You have to write a complex class hierarchy only for unit testing to run, because you can just create the object by hand. You have to use the IOC container. DI is a hot topic today, but there are downsides. If you have a huge complex objects graph and for bad luck some of the nodes are broken, you have a very large stack trace for solving. Usually the message doesn't point directly to the bad ones, but shows you all the graph making hard, giving a solution fast. Some Martin Fowler devices. There are three main styles of dependency injections. The names I'm using for them are constructor injection, shader injection, and interface injection. If you read about this stuff in the current discussions about inversion of control, you will hear it is referred to as a type 1 IOC interface injection, type 2 IOC shader injection, and the type 3 IOC constructor injection. I find numeric names rather hard to remember, which is why you've used the names I have here. Interface injection is more invasive since you have to write a lot of interfaces to get things all sorted out. For a small set of interface required by container, such as in Avalon's approach, this isn't too bad. But it's a lot of work for assembly components and dependencies, which is why the current crop of lightweight containers go with shader and constructor injection.
Do this to me, please.
Doing what? What do you mean?
Come on. Mary, please go.
Follows 15, a world is fully accepted by preeminent academics. Those critics against a wall, much of them are not because a wall is bad, but the way a wall concepts are applied is a holy grail that tends to abuse, motivates a strong wave of criticism. Some concepts like reuse are point of criticism like that. We can cite this amazing keynote, "Are We There Yet?" from Hickey, to raise some important misconceptions about a wall.
A rose must remain with the sun and the rain, or its lovely promise won't.